स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 1.2 ऑफ क्लास 10 एनसीईआरटी। सी, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गिवन, एक्सप्रेस ईच ऑफ ईच नंबर एज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ इट्स प्राइम फैक्टर। यू हैव टू एक्सप्रेस फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ इट्स प्राइम। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गिवन 140। यू हैव टू राइट इन राइट साइड एंड you have to get prime factor of it. Clear? It is an even number because it ends with digit 0. It is divisible by first prime number 2. It becomes 7 and then 0. Again, even divide by 2. 35. It is not divisible by 2. Then by you have to check by 3. 3 plus 5, 8. 8 is not divisible by 3. Then it will be divisible by 5. 5, 7, then by 7. Then here 1. So this is the prime factor of 140. You can write 2, how many times? 2 times. Then 5, then 7. Hence, the product of the prime factors of 140 is equal to 2 to the power 2 into 5 into 7 answer. Then I am going to solve third question of this. Third is given 3825. Again, you have to do in the same manner, 3825. Now, it is not an even number, it will be not divisible by 2, so check by 3, add this, 3 plus 8, 11, 2, 13, 5, 18, 18 is divisible by 3, it means the given number is divisible by 3, divide by second prime number 3, 3 1 ja 3, 3 2 ja 6, 2 remainder will be left, then 22, 7 ja 1 remainder left, then 5. Now check again by 3. This become 3, 7, 10, 5, 15. Again divisible by 3. 4, 2, 5. Again check by 3. So not divisible. So then divide by 5. 5, 8, 40. 5, 5, 25. Divide by 5. 5, 1, 5, 7. 17 is already prime number. Therefore, 3825 is equal to 3 square, because 2 times 5 square, 2 times then 17. Hence, the product of the prime factors of 3825 is equal to 3 square into 5 square into 17 answer. Next, if you want to do question number 2, question number 2, LCM and SCF you have to find and then you have to verify. The first question is given 26. And 91. 26 and 91. So you can get, if instruction is not given how to find SCF and LCM, you can get this SCF and LCM by prime factorization method. So I am going to divide 26 to 13. 13 is already prime number 1. Then 91. 91, it comes in table of 7. 7 1 ja, 7 3 ja. And 13 is already a prime number. Therefore, 26 is equal to 2 into 13. I have written as the product of its prime factor. And then 91, 3, not 3, 7 into 13. This is 7. 7 into 13. So therefore, if you want to get SCF of 26, this bracket will be read as of 91. So whatever common in both will be LCM. And LCM of 26 and 91, whatever is common, 30, and non-common number 2 and 7. Multiply it. How? 13 to the 26, 7. Now multiply. 7, 6 are 42, 4, 7 to the 14, and 4, 18. So this is LCM. Then you have to verify. So now, LCM into HCF is equal to, LCM is 182 and HCF is 30. You know the product. 13 to the 26, 2, 13, 8 are 104, 2, 106, and 31 are 13 and 10, 23. So this is the product. And just after this, and product of two numbers. Product of number 26 and 91 is equal to 26 into 91. You can multiply in the upper column 91 into 26. 6, 9, 6 are 54. 10, 2, and 9, 2 are 18. Then 6, 3, 2. You observe 2, 3, 6, 6. Here and here both are same. Hence, HCF into LCM is equal to product of two numbers. Verified. It is applicable. This is a formula. This is applicable for only two numbers, not for three. Next, one more question I am going to tell about this. Second, question number second, third. Second, third question. See, 336. And next is given 54. You have to follow the same steps. 336, get it prime factorized. 16, 8. Again, even 8, 4. 4, 2. 2, 1. 3, 7. 7, 1. Here, 54. 2, 27. 3, 9. 3, 3. 3, 1. Here you will write 336 is equal to how many times? 2? 4 times. 2 to the power 4. Then 3 power 1. Then 7 power 1. You can write 10, 54. What will be? 2 power 1, 3 power 3. Therefore, HCF. Firstly, you will get HCF of 336 and 54. This bracket is read as off. Now, whenever you are going to take HCF, what number is common? You have to take least power as common. Here 4 power, here 1. You have to take 2 to the power 1. Here both are common, but power 1 is least. The LCM will be, HCF will be 2, 3, 6. And LCM of 336 and 54. So now, whenever you are going to find out LCM, so whatever common, you have to take highest power, 2 to the power 4, here 3 to the power 3, then 7 is, and you have to take non-common also. While you are going to find out LCM of two numbers, you have to take common with highest power and non-common number, and multiply it. It will be 16, it will be 27, this will be 7. Now 16 multiplied by 7, 7, 7 is 49, 14 to 18. 16, 69 is 144, 14 carry. 14 carry, 128, add it, 2, 3, 4. Again 14 carry, 2 here.
16 बन जा
16
अब एट
30
इन दिस वे वी गॉट एलसीएम एंड एचसीएफ नाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड एलसीएम इनटू एचसीएफ व्हाट इज एलसीएम 3024 एंड दिस इज 6 यू सिंपली मल्टीप्लाई 6 फोर द 24 6 टू द 12 अ टू 14 एंड 6 थ्री जा 18 नाउ एंड product of 336 and 51 336 into 54 in the upper column multiply 1, 4, 1, 8, 1, 4, 4. So both are same. You observe from here. Therefore, or hence, SCF into LCM is equal to product of two numbers. Verify. This question is asked in 3 marks. If SCF and LCM is being asked, it will be of 1 or 2 marks, and the verification along with that is given. Then after this question will be coming in 3 marks. Be aware about it. Now we are in question number 3. Next question number 3. Again you have to find SCF and LCM by prime factorization method. First question is given 12. 15 and 20. Here we have to follow the same procedure 12 divisible by 2 again by 2 3 then 15 by 3 5 by 5 then 21 by 3 7 by 7 1 here you will write 12 is equal to 2 to the power 2 into 3 then 15 3 to the into 5 then 21 3 into 7 now you have to find SCF of 12 15 and 21 here you observe 3 is common in all the 3 is SCF and LCM of 12 15 and 21. You have to write common firstly, then non-common and multiply it. You observe 4, 3, 12, 5, 60 into 7, 40, 2, 420. In this way, you can solve question number 3. Then come to question number 4. 4, SCF of two number is given. You have to find LCM. LCM of 306, 657 is equal to product of two numbers upon SCF of 306. 5, 657. So what will be product? 306 into 657 and SCF is given 9. SCF is given 9. You observe if you add this become 9, it is divisible by 9. 9, 3 are 27, 3, 9, 4 are 36. Now you have to multiply 657 by 34. 7, 4 are 28, 5, 4 are 20. And 2, 22, 6, 4, 24, 2, 26, 10, 7, 3, 21, 5, 3, 15, 2, 17, and 6, 3, 18, and 1, 19. Now add it, 3, then 13, then 12, then 2. This will be 2, 2, 3, 3, 8, means 22,338.
will be the answer. Next, question number 5. Now, question number 5. Question number 5 is, check whether 6 to the power n can ends with digit 0 for any natural number n. If 6 to the power n ends with digit 0, it must have 5 as a prime factor. But 6 to the power n can be written 2 into 3 to the power n, can be written 2 to the power n into 3 to the power n. So thus 6 to the power n has only 2 and 3 as prime factor. By fundamental theorem of arithmetic, every composite number can be expressed as the product of its primes uniquely. Hence, six power n can never ends with digit 0. It means 6 has only 2 factor, 2 and 3. If 6 has only 2 and 3 as prime factor, it means 6 to the power n has only 2 and 3 as prime factor. And we have to show that it ends with 0. So it must have 5 as prime factor, but here is no possibility of 5 in the prime factor of 6 to the power n by fundamental theorem of arithmetic. That's why it can never end with digit 0. Next question is 7 into 11. Question number 6. 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13. We have to express that it is a composite number. We have to show that how it is a composite number. You observe 13 is common here. Take out common. 7 into 11 left. Here 1 is left. Now 13, 77 plus 1 means 13 into 78. You observe here. It means in 78 other factors are also possible. Clearly, the given number has more than 2 factors. Therefore, it is a composite number. Similarly, we can do the second part. If you are not able to get in here, in 78 you can break up and you can see 2, 3 is 39 will be left, 3 into 30. This is other prime factor of this number. It means it has more than 2 factors. That's why it is a composite number. The second part of this question can be solved in the same manner. That's why I am leaving it. Now last question of the exercise 7. Here there is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one round and Ravi takes 12 minutes for the same. Means one round Sonia is taking 18 minutes and to complete one round Ravi is taking 12 minutes. If both are starting at the same time from the same point, after how many minutes in the same direction, after how many minutes they will meet at the same point, so you have to get LCM of 12 and 18. 12 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3, and 18 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3. It means 2 to the power 2, 3 to the power 1. It can be written 2 to the power 1 and 3 to the power 2. Therefore, LCM of 12 and 18. Maximum power we take 2 to the power 2 and 3 to the power 2. Here 4, here 9, here 36. Therefore, we will write answer with the help of question. After how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Hence, they will meet again, they will meet again at the starting point, at the starting point. It is given in question. After 36 minutes, answer. In this way, we got through exercise 1.1, class 10th, NCERT. I hope you understand the exercise well, and subscribe my YouTube channel, and simply encourage me with your like. Thanks.